Hey, this is the Daily Overpass. My name is Eric and I make apps. Now today I want to talk about how you can increase your salary as a software developer. So today I'm coming to you from Green Park in Reading, which is this big industrial business park. I was here for a seminar, which just let out a little while ago, and I thought I'd take a little walk around. And this place is nice. I mean, like one day, you know, you see something like this, you think one day I want Overpass to be at an office complex like this, because there's like, you know, there's a big lake in the middle, all these big glass buildings, there's walkways here. You see a bunch of young technology people walk there with their name badges on, walking around, everything. Kind of like a, like when you see the Google complex, everything like that. And it's really nice. In fact, we are moving to a new office in Wantage here soon. So I was just yesterday looking at some new offices, and we will be moving here within the next month. Something a bit nicer, right? It's just need to, you know, now that we're getting some employees and stuff, try to, you know, grow a little bit. So anyway, I wanted to start off today by thanking everyone for the live stream last week. I did the first live stream on Thursday night, and I was really nervous. I wasn't sure if I was gonna have enough stuff to talk about. I appreciate everybody who showed up and asked questions and everything. And we're gonna do it again this Friday, this next Friday here at 8 p.m. UK time, which I think is noon on the Pacific Coast in California. And so if it's something if you're interested in attending the next live stream, it'd be really great to have you there. And if you have any questions that you want to ask, we could put it to the group. So it's not just me, because I'm not an expert on anything, but we could put it to the group. And if you want us to look at your Google Play page or anything like that, that might be kind of fun too. But if you're brave enough for everyone to see it and give a bit of constructive criticism, but it's a really good group. So anyway, that's there. And also I want to say thanks everyone for liking and subscribing and sharing the content here on the channel. I'm supposed to say that at the beginning. So today I want to talk about developer salaries, right? Because I was talking to a friend.
I am so sorry for this awkward transition, right? I filmed that entire video out at Green Park, right? It was beautiful scenery, people walking by, everything, right? And the microphone failed halfway through it. So I got like a lot of footage of me just like an idiot with no audio. So sorry about that. Sorry for this awkward transition. So what I was telling you about was a couple of days ago, I was contacted by a friend of mine that I used to work with when I worked at an investment bank as a contractor. See, this must have been about 12, 13, 14 years ago, right? And I was like, it was one of my first contracts, and I was, you know, my rate kept going up and up, and I was like making like £375 a day working at this investment bank, which I thought was really good. And it is really good, right? So I was, as a developer, a lot of, back then it was a lot of ASP stuff. It wasn't even ASP.NET, it was a lot of VB, you know, COM components, stuff like that, you know, that kind of stuff, right? And there was a guy who came in, so this guy came in as a consultant to work on this one project, on this one trading system that we worked on together. So it was like an older legacy system, and I was writing the new kind of glue that connected it to other systems, kind of the piping and everything like that. And he was like, and we talked a lot at lunch, and he knew this one technology, which is older technology, Unix-based, right? And we talked, and I kept trying to tell him he should learn ASP or ASP.NET so that he could get, because there's more job opportunities in that language that I have. And I was like, I was very much like, you know, if you spend so much time looking for work, I would say, you know, you should learn this technology because there's lots of jobs, right? I'm like thinking you should do the thing that there's lots of jobs for. And then one day I found out how much he was being paid. Like, we just having a conversation, I was making £375 a day and he was making over £1,000 a day. Right? It was like, I couldn't believe it. I thought, you know, he's making, you know, actually, I think he was making three times more than me. It was more than £1,000 a day, right? And it turns out that because there were not a lot of people who could do what he could do, right? Or there was like, the market was full of ASP developers. It was full of PHP developers, full of all these developers. Everyone goes looking for a job. You look for the one with the most job opportunities. But that meant that the supply was bigger than the demand, so that they could lower down the rate. So this guy was making like loads because there was only a handful of people in the world who can do what he did, right? On the other, so then I started asking around, I started thinking about this thinking, wow, I didn't think I was actually on a low rate. So I started asking around, there was another team that were mostly Java developers, Java and some older technology, I can't remember what it was, but it was like, so they used some older technologies and everything like that, and I started asking them, and they were making more too, because it was hard to find the skills that they had, even though what the skills they had used to be mainstream, but they were older technologies. It wasn't Java, it was, I'm thinking Pascal, I can't remember what it was, but it was old. It was an old technology, and these guys, they were like, they knew it, so they were able to charge more, right? And it made me start thinking about the distribution curve. So I don't know if you've ever seen the distribution curve, where it's like the bell curve, and you've got the early adopters, the early majority, the late majority, and the laggards that come on behind. Right, it made me start thinking about technology and being able to raise your rate as a developer. So it seemed to me like if you were like in the early majority and you have a skill that's not very widely used yet, you might not find a lot of jobs in that. So like right now, maybe Flutter might be a good one now. So if you were just becoming a developer and you went to go learn Flutter, you might have a hard time finding a job, right? But you'd be able to charge a lot more because there's fewer people in that market, right? As soon as it gets to the early majority, and right now the early majority, in my opinion, is probably like React Native, you know, Ionic, Native, all that kind of stuff. And then you got the late majority, which is definitely PHP, right? You know, I could throw a stick out the window and hit a PHP developer. There are so many out there, so the rates are much lower. You got PHP, you know, C#, that kind of stuff. And then you got the late majority, which is like, you know, the laggards, which is like, you know, Perl and all this, you know, ASP, classic ASP, VB6, that kind of stuff. That, you know, those people could probably charge a lot more because it's hard to find those kind of developers with those skills to look at the old stuff. So my advice always to new developers is to look at that center section for the job that you're going to go out, because you don't want to learn a technology where you can't find a job in. But at the same time, focus on the early majority, because that's, you know, if you can learn those technologies while you learn the other thing, while you're learning React Native, also learn something that's cutting edge. And I say Flutter, but there's probably things that are more cutting edge than that now, right? And there's always machine learning and AI and all the other cool stuff that's coming out. But if you were to learn that early majority stuff right now, eventually it might become the majority, and then the rates will go down as more people flood into the market. But if you hold on to those skills as you get older, you might be able to charge more again at the late majority. So anyway, those are just my opinions. After talking to him, it was funny. It was, you know, he was doing okay. I was like worried about him, saying, if you can't find any jobs, you should learn ASP. And he had no problem. So anyway, sorry about the audio problems today. That's it for today. I'll talk to you tomorrow.